Sure, WooCommerce might be free, but WooCommerce subscriptions is $279 per site per year. That is absolutely insane. That's why when I saw WP subscription over on AppSumo, I just knew I had to check it out. With plans starting as low as $59, this could definitely save some serious cash. There are three plans available on AppSumo, Tier 1, Tier 2, and Tier 3. The difference is, right now at least, only the number of websites that you get access to: one website, five websites, or unlimited. Now keep in mind that this is a one-time payment versus a yearly fee from WooCommerce, so yeah, I'm definitely interested. Now I've actually done quite a bit of testing already and I've got a lot to say, but first let me just show you how the plugin works. So you can see I've got it installed over here. As soon as you purchase from AppSumo, you'll get your license key and a download link so you can go ahead and get it set up on your own website. This is just a website that I use for testing, so I'm going to do some kind of funky things here, but let's see how to set up at least a basic subscription. So you'll want to go ahead and just create a WooCommerce product the same way you always would. Just go add new product under the products tab, and I'm going to call this one yearly widgets because I want to sell you a widget that arrives at your house once per year. The experience so far is just like using WooCommerce. You can add in a product description, set up a product image. I'm going to go with this car, enter in a price. And then where things get a little bit different is now that I have WP subscription installed, I've got a subscription checkbox over here. Now this differs right away from the way WooCommerce's own subscription plugin works because they add a different product type. So here it says simple product. And by the way, this plugin, WP subscription, works with both simple products and variable products. But if I were using WooCommerce subscriptions, this is confusing already, but that's the official plugin. If I was using the official plugin, I would see subscription listed over here. So just know that that's one little way that it works a little bit differently. For now, I'm just going to stick with a simple product and I'll check the subscription box. What's going to happen when I do this? Watch over here on the left-hand menu. It's going to add an entirely new section where I get a bunch of additional options. Now I'm going to click into the subscription options over here and I can set up the subscription payment plan. So you can see that users will pay every day, week, month, or years, and we can set this to be whatever we like. So let's say I wanted to have them, you know, charged once per year, I could set it to be every 1 year. A more common situation would probably be something like once per month, once per week, or you could really set it up to be whatever makes sense for your products. Now there is a free version of this plugin, so you can definitely try it out and see if it does what you need, but you'll miss out on some of the features like this one right here to offer a free trial. So if you've got a membership site and you want to offer a free 7-day trial to it, you might want to go ahead and enter in a value here. Now, I don't want any free trials right now, so I'm just going to leave that blank. And it's also very common to set up a signup fee when you begin a new subscription. If you want to have a signup fee, again, go ahead and enter in a value here. For this demo product, I'm going to leave it blank. All right, next I want to talk about this feature here, limit subscription. The default setting is do not limit, meaning that someone can buy multiple subscriptions of the same product. You can also set it to allow only one active subscription of that product or only one active subscription of a particular status. Now, I'm going to go ahead and just leave this off for now, but I kind of want to call out the official documentation from WP subscription because inside of that, they actually mention this as though it's some kind of a split pay option. What I'm actually talking about is on their official YouTube channel. So go to @WPSubscription and just watch this introducing WP subscription video because inside of it, the narrator very clearly defines the option I'm talking about right now as a way to set a number of charges that will occur to the customer. A feature I would very much like to see, but actually doesn't exist in the plugin right now. So just keep that in mind. It's kind of my first critique of this video. There is no way to do split pays or a limited number of charges that I can see anywhere in the tool right now. There's an option here to customize the add to cart text. That's just fine. It says the default setting is subscribe. In my theme, it didn't update. It still says add to cart, and I'll show you that momentarily. The next option here is can the user cancel? They actually spelled the word cancel wrong here, and this is user selectable. So you can say no if you want to have them maybe email email support to cancel or leave it to yes, and they will actually be able to cancel their subscription right from the My Account page, which again, I will show you momentarily. The next settings down here under delivery settings only apply if you're doing a physical good. If you're doing a virtual good, notice they disappear entirely. So what we're alluding to here is if you have, let's say, a subscription, I don't know, it seemed like box services were very popular. You get dog treats in a box, you get books in a box. I don't know what people are buying in boxes these days, but let's say you had a subscription service like that. You could set up a specific schedule, or you could sync everybody so that they get the product on the same day. So if I enable this button right down here, I can have the deliveries always go out on Mondays. Now, this is really great in concept, but I think it might make more sense to say particular days of the month, like you'll get it on the 1st and the 15th, something like that. That would be a really cool option. I'm thinking of like Mark Rober's, kind of box thing that he's got. I think it's called Crunch Labs, right? That comes out like, say, at the beginning of every single month. It'd be great to be able to synchronize that to always go out at the start of the month. Come to think of it, with Crunch Lab, it's also a one-year commitment, meaning that you're signing up for a subscription, but it ends after 12 months. So again, kind of going back to the limit subscription option here, I really wish that was a number, a selector that I could enter in, you know, only charge the customer 12 times, 6 times, something like that. Now, I'm mentioning some downsides here, but overall, the basic functionality works quite well. So I've got everything set up. I've got a price entered in. I can add a description if you like. There's my simple description. Let's go ahead and publish this product. All right, now I've got my product URL right here. I can open this up and we can check it out. Now I'm just using GeneratePress for my WordPress theme here. It's not really WooCommerce optimized. You can make this checkout page look however you want using any WooCommerce theme that fits your style. Just know that this part is completely customizable. In fact, you could even use it with a funnel builder. I tested it with FunnelKit and it worked just fine there. So I'm gonna go ahead and just make a purchase here. So I'm gonna add the yearly widget to my cart. And now here is my cart. Now, often, truthfully, I usually skip this page on WooCommerce stores that I build out, and I just send people right to the checkout. This page isn't very useful, especially when it comes to conversions. But you can see here the reoccurring totals, and I think this is very important because you never want to trick your customer into buying a reoccurring subscription when they think they're just buying a one-time product. So I like very much that this is very forward, easy to see. All right, I'm going to be billed again in a year, and I can cancel the subscription at any time. One bit of feedback is that you cannot change this text easily within the plugin. I wish there was a way to just modify it. Like, I don't need the exclamation mark there. It's a little bit much, but maybe I'd like to add a link to the terms and conditions of canceling. Anyway, there's just no way to really customize this little section without injecting some code on your own. But let's proceed to the checkout here. I've got this all set up for testing so I can actually complete the checkout. So I've got my billing details entered in here, and you can see I've actually got the test card stored as my actual card. I'm gonna go ahead and place the order. I will point out again that it does say the reoccurring totals again here on the checkout page. So let's place this order, and it is processing using Stripe right now. A very important point. This plugin only works with Stripe, PayPal, and Paddle out of the box. And they really want you to use the official integrations for both Stripe, PayPal, and Paddle. So no third-party tools here. I know a lot of people like to use third-party Stripe plugins. I myself often use a third-party Stripe plugin, but that is not compatible yet. It did say on the AppSumo page that they're looking for suggestions for other payment providers to support next. So definitely, if you check this out and you want to use it, but with a different payment provider, definitely let them know so that they can kind of prioritize what the audience actually wants to utilize. But as you can see here, my order has been received. Everything worked as you would expect. Now, what happens if I actually want to cancel this as a customer? What is that process like? Well, when you install WP Subscriptions, it actually adds a tab to your My Account settings. This is a default page that's created with WooCommerce. You can go ahead and set it up again inside of the tools if you don't have it on your website. That's the WooCommerce tools under settings. You can just have it add those default pages, but you probably have it already. It's just slash My Account, and you can see right here it says Subscriptions. If I click on this, I can see all of my active subscriptions. I've got 3 active subscriptions and one that is pending cancellation. So here's the one we just bought, right? That's the most recent one. So I can go ahead and look at the overall subscription details here. I can see that it's active. I can see when my next payment due date is. I can see what method it's using, credit card via Stripe. Although I don't get any details about like what card will be charged as a user, that might be helpful to see the last four or something. But if I want to cancel this, I can click right here and then I will not be charged again. A little bit slow here, but this is just my testing site. There we go. And now it is pending cancellation. If I decide that I change my mind, I want to reactivate this cancellation before my next payment due date, I can just click right here and we'll go ahead and set up that purchase all over again, one click. So all of these basic features work great. If that is all you need WooCommerce subscriptions to do, you can go ahead and ditch the official plugin and pick up the lifetime deal on AppSumo. But there are some more things to talk about. Like maybe you happen to notice this. When I was on the subscriptions tab over here, look what happens to my menu. It hijacks everything. Why is it doing that? I have no idea. If I look at the URL that these are going to, check out my status bar down there. My subscriptions is going to the homepage, then it's going to the events page, then it's going to services. So it didn't actually change the link. It just actually broke the menu itself. I mean, check it out. Let's go to the dashboard. All of my navigation comes back. Just definitely a weird bug. I can't even begin to fathom how that is happening. Another thing that irks me that might seem OCD to the average person, but will definitely bother other WordPress professionals, is the fact that WP Subscription adds their own item over here on the left-hand sidebar, but they also add it to the same section inside of WooCommerce. This takes me to the same place that this does, and I can't remove this inside of the settings. Sure, I could use some kind of customization to hide it, but give me an option inside of settings, or better yet, just leave it nested inside of WooCommerce. That is what the subscription plugin from WooCommerce themselves does. I think it's good enough. The overall settings inside of WP Subscription are just fine. I can see all of my subscriptions here. I can see who is active. I can take actions if I want to, like maybe cancel someone manually. So let's go ahead and cancel this subscription right here. It's going to process it and the person won't be charged again. It also links every transaction to a real purchase inside of WooCommerce, just like I'd want them to do. So I can click right here and it's going to take me over to the actual order inside of WooCommerce. You can see my navigation. I'm on WooCommerce orders and I can see all of my order details here, as well as the order notes as they went through the entire checkout process. There's also a decent reporting section over here where I can see how many active subscribers I have, what my total will be for this month, as well as my projection for next month. And in the settings tab, I can go ahead and configure things just a little bit more, such as the renewal process. By default, that is automatic. That is what most people will want to leave it as. But if you are a crazy person, you could set it up to be manual as well. And that way your customers will have to actively manually resubscribe every time their membership is due for renewal. If you're looking to use WP Subscription as more of a membership plugin, it's not really intended to be used that way. It's really just meant to take automatic payments on a set basis. They do have this feature right here based around the WordPress role system. So most people are familiar with the idea of like administrator, editor, author, things like that. But additional roles can be created inside of WordPress. So they've got one here called subscriber. So when someone makes a purchase, they will be assigned the subscriber role. And if someone ends their subscription, you can change them to be something else like customer because they purchased in the past or whatever else you'd like to add in. And there's lots of role management plugins available for WordPress, so you can find your favorite one and set this up to work just as you'd like. But for those people looking to maybe lock down content and make it available on a subscription basis, this isn't really meant to do that. You'll need other plugins to work with it to get that functionality. The other downside I'd mention is maybe just a little bit of speculation about what's going to actually happen with this plugin in the future. It looks to me like it was recently acquired. So here is the free version over on the WordPress repository, right? So this is going to have limited features compared to everything we just saw, but you can definitely check it out and see if it does what you need before making a purchase, of course. But it was owned by this guy right here. It looks like he may have sold this to another company. So here's their website, wpsubscription.co. Now this is actually owned, if I scroll all the way to the bottom, owned by a company called Converse Lab. Now I believe that Converse Lab is actually owned by the same company that does Thrivedesk, which is what the tool is that you see over here, powered by Thrivedesk. I see all these faces up here. I recognize a few of them. So if you know Thrivedesk, it was an old lifetime deal. The team that ran Thrivedesk is also, I believe, taking on WP Subscription as one of their new products. And so they will be leading it into the future. Is that good or is that bad? I'm not saying one way or another, but this does appear to be a recently acquired product. So they'll probably have a little bit of work to do to get up to snuff and maybe add in new features that they think are essential. So is this worth $59 or $249 for unlimited? Well, yeah, probably if it does the things that you need. I would say this is definitely just a simpler, more affordable version of WooCommerce subscriptions. I am sick of paying $270 a year. You probably are as well. If this does everything you need, it's definitely worth checking out. In case you haven't seen one of my videos recently, I did retire this scoring system and I moved to a tier system. Now, I don't have another plugin to compare this to because I've never seen another lifetime deal for a subscription product. But if I'm comparing it directly to WooCommerce subscriptions, I would say if it's really critical, maybe you're doing hundreds of thousands of dollars per month on your subscription website, go with the official plugin. But if you're just getting going, well, this one is probably going to be good enough for you. But keep in mind that as you grow, switching over to different systems is not easy to do. You kind of got to stick a platform and keep with it because importing and exporting subscriptions can be a bit tricky, and it's not something you want to have to spend your time doing. So hopefully this information has been helpful to you. If it has, I've got my AppSumo affiliate link in the description. Go ahead and click that before making a purchase for WP Subscription or anything else at AppSumo. I'll still get credit even if you use the link down below. Thank you very much for watching. Hit me up with any questions in the comments, and I'll see you in the next review.